Good morning, students. Here I am once again, Hemant Bhatia, with the 9th mathematics class. Today we are going to learn a new topic, that is algebraic identities. It comes under the polynomial only, but in NCERT it is only having a one exercise. But as you can go to the reference books like R.D. Sharma, it is expanded up to 5 chapters. Okay, so I am trying to conclude it at once only. So let's start. Okay, in this algebraic identities, you have already learned some of the identities in your previous class. Okay, so here I am bunching some of the identities together and we'll see one example of each. Okay, now our first three identities is that you have learned in your previous class, that is a plus b whole square, that is a square plus 2ab plus b square. Second, it is a minus b whole square, that is a square minus 2ab plus b square. Okay, third one is a square minus b square, which is a plus b a minus b. Okay, last year, if you remember, you have learned a common column method, which is actually the presentation of this one first and second identity, how to find the square by using these identities that you have seen last year. Now I am just showing you one of the practical example of first identity, how it will work. Now see, suppose there is a square. Okay, I am making a square. Okay, now what I am doing is I just separate two parts of it. Okay, so I am marking a point here. Till that, this distance we are assuming it as a, and the other distance which are shorter we are assuming it as a b. Okay, likewise we will do same to each and every side of the square. This is your a and this b. This is b and this is a. Okay, this is a and this b. Okay, now do one thing. What you can do is you can divide this square in two parts, because the side is divided, you divided already it in two parts, a and b. So what we are doing here, taking this a and making a square. Okay, so that each side of it is an a. Okay, and here as you can see the remaining part is b, so that this length is b, this also b, this also b, and that is also b. So here this square is a square and this square is showing us the b square. Now if you see these two other two squares, okay, it is not a square actually, it is a rectangle of length a and b. So their areas are a into b, length into b, area of rectangle. Okay, now by showing areas of different rectangle and square, we are concluding it. So the whole square area is side square, the side is a plus b. So a plus b whole square is including a square of side a, a square of side b, and two rectangle of side a into b area. So this is how your identity works. Okay. This is only just practical. We will do it later in the class when the class will start. Okay. Till then, just remember it. Okay. Now we will see some of the question. Okay. Beside of that, we have learned the fourth identity in your eighth class. If you remember it well, it is x plus a x plus b. We actually talked about it in our previous classes. It is x square a plus b x a into b. Okay, so we'll see now one each example of each identity. Now first identity example. Okay, example one. Okay, in example one, suppose we have to find the square of any number. Okay, so we are taking here 110 square. Okay, now 110 is a single unit number. Okay, but we are actually dividing it in two parts so that we can get our A and B as well. So what we are doing here, we can write 110 as 100 plus 10 whole square. Okay, now 100 assumes as our A and 10 we are assuming as our B. Okay, so A plus B whole square, it looks like A plus B whole square. We can apply this identity now. So that we can write it as A square, that means 100 square, B square, that is 10 square, and 2AB, that is 2 into 100 into 10. Rather than multiplying 110 by 110 and trying to find out the answer, it will be easy to us to find the answer by the identity. 100 square is 10,000. It's easy to square 100, like 1 square is 1 and double 2 square is 4 times 0. Okay. 10 square is 100 and 8 multiplied product is 2000. We can now add on all this number. Now this will become is 10,000 and 2000 is 12,100, and that is our answer. Okay, it's very simple to apply this kind of identities. Okay, let me show you one more example of the same identity. Okay, but sometimes what we can do is we can change this identity also. Okay, how to change this identity? It's also very easy. Like here I am taking as 98 square plus 2 square. Now we are taking it as A square plus B square. Now you can tell me that we didn't learn A square plus B square identity, but by using this identity we will make A square plus B square identity. How we can make it? See, what we can do is A square and B square we are remaining here. We just transpose this 2AB to other side. So that this identity will get changed, it will become A plus B whole square minus 2AB. Because as you know that A plus B whole square is now A square plus B square plus 2AB, minus 2AB will get cancelled, so that A square plus B square will remain. So we are doing it. So what we are doing here with 98 and 2, we can write 98 plus 2 whole square minus 2 into 98 into 2. Okay, 98 plus 2 is 100. 100 square minus 2 2's are 4 and 98 4's are here taking, 4 8's are 32, 4 9's are 36 and 3 39. Now we just subtract 392 from 10,000, okay, which will gives us 608. This will be the answer. And that is actually the solution of this algebraic expression. Now, so that's how we can use this first identity A plus B whole square. Okay, you can try some more questions. Now, we are moving to next identity, which is A minus B whole square. Now, for A minus B whole square, I am taking another example, example number 2. The question I am taking is 97 whole square. Now, 97 you all know it is number closer to 100, but it is less than 100. How much it is less? It is less 3. So we can write 100 minus 3 square. Okay, 100 minus 3 is 97, 97 whole square. Now, we can apply A minus B whole square identity. Now, our A is 100 and our B is 3. Now we are applying this identity. So A square plus B square. Remember this 3 is negative, but when we square it, the negative becomes positive. Plus 3 square minus 2 into 100 into 3. 100 square again is 10,000 plus 9 minus 600. Now 10,000 minus 600 is 9,400 plus 9, which gives us 9,409, and that is our answer. Okay, it's simply what we have done here is we just simply using that identity to get the square of 97. Okay, you can use different identities for different perspective. It depends on what you are assuming, what you are thinking about the number, what you are actually focusing about the number. Okay, now The next thing is different question of that. Okay. Once I will show you one more example of the third and fourth identity. The third identity is a square minus b square. I am taking one of the example of it, like it is given in NCERT. Like for third identity, I am taking 3 minus 2x and 2x plus 3. Okay, it does not matter that if numbers are in negative, the sequence is not important. When the number is in subtraction, the sequence is important. Okay, so we can assume that 2x plus 3 or 3 plus 2x is the same. So I do not change this first term 3 minus 2x. I am keeping it as it is. I am changing this second term to 3 plus 2x. Now this will look the same, a minus b, a plus b. Okay, our a is 3 and our b is 2x. Okay, this will result a square minus b square. So we can write it as 3 square minus 2x whole square. Okay, 3 square is 9 and 2x whole square is 4x square, and that is our answer. Okay, this is the example for third identity, a plus b, a minus b. Now moving on to the fourth identity, which is x plus a, x plus b. Okay, x plus a, x plus b identity. I am taking here two numbers, but I will try to get some negative sign also. So I am taking it as x minus a and x plus 10. As you can see that here one term is common, which is x, and 8 and 10 are two different terms as a and b. So x plus a, x plus b are identity we are applying. You can object me that 8 is negative, so how a plus x plus a, x plus b? See, we can take the sign of 8 as well, but we are applying the identity, the same identity what we have written. Now see, we are assuming it as x plus a, x plus b. So x square plus a plus b. So minus 8 I am taking here because 8 is having negative sign. Then plus a into b, again minus 8 into 10. Okay, now just solve it. Minus 8 plus 10, how much? That is plus 2, yes, correct. And minus 18. This is our answer. That's how we can apply that identity. Okay, one more question. I am taking it from NCERT book. I am trying to take some questions from NCERT so that you can connect as well. Like one more example, that first question's third example is 3x plus 4 and 3x minus 5. Now again you can see the x term, the first term is common in both, but the second term is different in both. Okay, and I am taking here a minus also, so that you can relate it or apply it nicely. Now x plus a, x plus b, so that x is square, that is 3x whole square, plus a plus b. Remember our b is negative, so that I am taking negative sign here, x plus a into b. Okay, now 3x whole square is 9x square, 4 minus 5 is minus 1 into 3x, power 5 is 20. I am solving it this negative term again, 9x square minus 3x minus 20, and that is your answer. Okay, this is how we can apply it. Since these identities are simple, you know, so that you can apply it easily, very easily, and it is very useful when once you comes in classroom. I will explain you more aspect of the same question. Okay, let's move on to the more identities now. There are total 10, 11 identities approx. Okay, so now we are moving on to three terms identity and cube identity. Okay, now see our fifth, sixth and seventh identity. Our fifth identity is a plus b whole cube, which is a cube plus b cube plus 3ab, a plus b, or else we can multiply this third term together so that we can have a cube plus b cube plus 3a square b plus 3ab square. Okay,
3ab into a is 3a square b, 3ab into b is 3ab square. Likewise, sixth identity is a minus b whole cube. Now see where minus will come. A cube minus b cube. Why minus b cube? Because b is negative and having an odd number as a power. When minus is having odd number as a power, it results in negative number. Minus 3ab, again b is odd, a minus b. Or we can write it as a cube minus b cube minus 3a square b plus 3ab square. Okay? One more identity I am taking here is a plus b plus c whole square, that is a square plus b square plus c square plus 2ab plus bc plus ca. Okay, it is the same of two variable identities like what we did in two numbers whole square, that is same is in three number whole square, but here terms will get there are more terms here because of the third input. Okay, now see first fifth identity, a plus b whole cube. Okay, a plus b whole cube and its reverse identity also I am showing you. Now see it is like I am taking an example like x by 2 plus 1 whole cube. Okay, now see, we are applying a plus b whole cube identity. A is x by 2 and our b is 1. Now, x by 2 cube, a cube, b cube is 1 cube, 3 into x by 2 into 1 and x by 2 plus 1. See, it's easier to apply, okay, like this. Now, this will become x cube by 8 plus 1 plus 3x by 2. X by 2 plus 1. Now we just multiply it. See, we can't leave questions like that. We have to multiply it anyhow. This will become 3x square by 4 plus 3x by 2. And that is our final answer. You can write it down with the decreasing of degree or the power. You can write it like all this also. Okay. Then a minus b whole cube example I am taking. In a minus b whole cube I am taking example like 2a minus 3b whole cube. 2a minus 3b whole cube. It is like a cube, that is our a is 2a, minus b cube, our b is minus 3b. Okay, then minus 3ab, a minus b. Okay, now 2a cube is 8a cube, minus 3 cube is 27b cube. It is 3 to the 6, 3 is 18ab, 2a minus 3b. Now we are multiplying 18ab to 2a minus 3. 8a cube minus 27b cube minus 18 to the 54b square b minus minus plus 18 3 is 36, 18 3 is 54 AB square. And that's how we apply the sixth identity there. Okay? Okay. Now A plus B plus C whole square identity I am applying. Okay. See that identity also, how to apply that identity. I am taking here a plus 2b plus 3c whole square. Okay, I am taking this example by myself. Now see, here a plus b plus c whole square is a square plus b. In the place of b, we have 2b, so that 2b square plus 3c square plus 2ab. That means a into 2b plus 2bc. That is 2b into 3c plus 2ca, that means 3c into a. Now, c a square, 2b whole square is 4b square, 3c whole square is 9c square, 2 and 2b will be 4ab. 2 into 2b into 3c will product gives us, it is a 6 to the 12bc, and last 2 to 3 is a 6c, and that is your answer.
Okay, very calm, very cool, very relaxing. You have to do the sums by doing it easily, thoroughly. You can apply each and every identity and keep the values of the variable correctly on their places so that you can get your answer easily. Okay, now we are moving on to our next identities, which are a cube plus b cube. It's our 8th identity if you numbering them correctly. So that a cube plus b cube gives you a plus b a square minus ab plus b square. Yes, you are seeing it correctly. Minus comes here. Why minus comes here? That is having another thing I am showing you. See, just we had an identity a plus b whole cube as a cube plus b cube plus 3ab a plus b, right? Now what we are doing here, we can transpose this 3ab a plus b to other side so that to get the value of a cube plus b cube. Right? A cube plus b cube will become then a plus b whole cube minus 3ab a plus b. Okay, now what we are doing here, we can take this a plus b common because it is in both terms once, so I am taking it once more. Now what we have remaining is a plus b square, because from 3 power 1 power we took out minus 3ab. Now just open this square. Okay, so a plus b will remain here. This a plus b square will be a square plus b square plus 2ab minus 3ab. This 2ab will get subtracted from this 3ab, will result minus ab. That's why here minus ab comes, and that's how we can get the identity of a cube plus b cube like this. Okay, likewise, it's our 8th identity. 9th identity is a cube minus b cube, and that is a minus b, because in the front a plus b, a cube plus b cube is there, the plus comes. When minus comes, so first term will be negative, and then a square plus ab plus b square will be the second term. You can try it with the a cube minus b cube, a minus b whole cube identity. You can simply just transpose this term like this, and you can get your next identity. Okay. Beside of that, I am taking the 10th identity, which can be a last identity, I wish. It is a cube plus b cube plus c cube minus 3abc is equals to a plus b plus c a square plus b square plus c square minus ab minus bc minus c. And it's very long because of the terms, because the terms like that. Okay, here one special case is there. This special case is what? Ki when a plus b plus c is 0, that means you have this two factors, one factor is 0, suppose. So that your a cube plus b cube plus c cube will equals to 3abc, because when you keep 0 here, 0 is 0 as you know, so that multiplication product of this whole term will become 0, so that when you get this whole terms equals to 0, you can simply transpose this minus 3abc, so it will come up to other side, so that it will resulting like this. When a plus b plus c is 0, a cube plus b cube plus c cube will be 3abc. It's very simple to understand, and it's very important also. It will be asked in the examination one by the other year. So now we are taking one example each of each identity. Yeah. Okay. First, we are taking the example for the first identity a cube plus b cube. Okay. I'm taking here as 102 cube. Okay. Writing example 8 because of the 8th question we are having. We are taking 102 cube. Okay. Plus 8 cube. Okay. Now, a cube plus b cube, we are assuming our a is 102, our b is 8. Now, we are applying this identity now here. So, we can write it as
a plus b, okay, a square plus b square plus minus ab, 1028. Now we just solve it. 102 plus 8 is 110, okay, and 102 is square. See, I am telling you how to square such kind of numbers. 1 is 2, so that 2 square is 04, and 10 will multiply to the next number is 11. 10 into 11 is 110. So that 102 square will be 11004. 8 square is 64, and 102 8za is 816. Because 8 2 is 16 and 100 times 8 is 800. Okay, now solve this whole term. This will 110. We can add these two numbers. This will become 11,068 minus 816 here. Now multiply 110 with this number. We can subtract it. 8 minus 6 is 2. Okay, 6 minus 1 is 5. 110 minus 8 is 102. Now we are multiplying it. 11 table you all know. 11 2s are 22. 11 5s are 55 and 257. 5 carry. 11 2s are 22 and 5 27. 2 carry. 11 0s are 0 and 2 2. 11 3 11 and 2 13. And 1 0 don't forget it. Okay, this is the result of this whole cube term. Okay, likewise you can apply a cube minus b cube identity as well. Okay, I'm not showing the example for it here. Yeah. Now we are seeing example for our last term, two examples for each. Okay, one of the question is given into our NCERT book. I would like to tell you that question of exercise 2.5, question number 12. Okay, question number 12 says that we have to verify that x cube, let me rub it because it is a very long question, it need more and more space. Okay, to use that space I need some broader area. Okay, let's see. Example 12, question 12, it says x cube plus y cube plus z cube minus 3xyz is equals to half x plus y plus z, okay, and in bracket it is x minus y whole square plus y minus z whole square plus z minus x whole square. Okay, see, this is very important to not to get afraid of question seeing like this big question, how we can do this. You just need to stick with your basic ideas that you need to apply the identity where it can be applicable. So we need to do the same thing here also. Don't afraid about this question. What we are doing here, we need to verify. So what we are taking is, we can take either left side or right side. See, it's easier to make big small, not to make small big. So that what we are taking here, we are taking RHS here. Okay, and we can try to consume and apply identity and get it shrink so that it can become equal to the LHS. So what we are doing here is RHS half x plus y plus z, we are remaining it same. What we can do here, we can apply each of the identity as a minus b whole square so that we can get is x square plus y square minus 2xy, y square plus z square minus 2yz, and z square plus x square minus 2zx. Okay, now do one thing. Just add the terms we are getting us same like terms. X square become 2x square, y square become 2y square, z square become 2z square. Then 2xy, 2yz, and 2zx. Okay, now half x plus y plus z, taking 2 common from all. Okay, here x square plus y square plus z square minus xy minus yz minus zx will remain. Okay, we can cancel this 2 from this half 1 by 2. Okay, the remaining thing is, as you can see, it's in part of the identity also. See, the same thing is in identity also. Or either you can multiply the whole term. I am multiplying here.
right? We can multiply the whole this term with x, so it will give us x cube plus x y square plus x z square minus x square y minus x y z minus z x square. Then we can multiply it with y, so that it will give us x square y plus y cube plus z y z square minus x y square minus y square z minus x y z. Then again with the z, x square z plus y square z plus z cube minus x y z minus y z square minus z square x. Now see, simply x z square and z square x will get cancelled. Likewise, you can cancel each and every term here. X y square we can cancel, which is minus x y square. X square y we can cancel it with this plus x square y. Y z square we can cancel with this minus y z square. This y square z minus we can cancel it with this plus y square z. Now see what is remaining here. Here x cube is remaining, y cube is remaining, and z cube is remaining. With x, y, z, x, y, z, x, y, z twice, we can write here 3x, y, z. This also term will get cancelled with this. All terms will get cancelled and only this will remain. And that is your RHS. So, like you can apply this identity. One more last question we can see about the identity. Okay. This will is for the special case. I am rubbing it because it's a very large question. I know that you guys are fedding up with this, but it's the part of our NCERT book, so we need to do that. Okay, sorry for that inconvenience. Now, see if question is given to us that 12 cube minus 7 cube minus 5 cube. Now, how to solve this? Okay, you don't need to find the cube of each of the number. You just see that whether we can apply any identity or not. It's actually showing at the example of our special case. As you can see that in singular, 12 minus 7 minus 5 will result in 0, because 7 and 5 become 12 and 12 minus 12 is 0. So this is the case where x plus y plus z becomes 0. And when x plus y plus z becomes 0, you all know that x cube y cube plus z cube result in what? It is a 3x, y, z. So what we can do here for 12 cube minus 7 cube minus 5 cube, we can just write it as 3, 12 into minus 7 into minus 5. I'm taking sign here also. Don't forget to take signs also. Okay? Otherwise your answer's sign will come incorrect. Now, just multiply it. See, 12 5s are 60, 63s are 180 into minus 7. Okay, 18 7s are. 18 7s are, you can separate it as 70 and 7 8s are 56. It will become 126. So, minus 12 60 is your answer for that question. Okay? So, please keep try solving question by the identities, use of the identity. Now, let's move on to other questions, some of the other questions like this. I'm rubbing it. Okay? Now, there are few questions who are having mixed terms in it. And you need to put them accordingly, like 3x minus 7y equals to 10. Okay, one of the values given to us, and xy equals to minus 1. That is actually x into y. There are three kinds of multiplication: dot multiplication, cross multiplication, and bracket multiplication. It is one of them. We need to find the value of 9x square plus 49y square. The value of this expression we need to find out. Now see how to find the value of this. Okay. As I have told you, we need to use the identity here. So what we are doing, we are simply using the identity. Okay. The value we need to find out, we can write it as a square. So we can write it as 3x whole square, that will be 9x square, and 7y whole square, that will be 49y square. Now, a square plus b square in terms of a minus b will be what? Because here a minus b is given. So, it will be a minus b whole square and plus 2ab. So, in terms of x and y, what will come here? 3x and 7y. Okay, likewise we can put the value here. This we have arranged in a formula of
a square plus b square in terms of a minus b. So here we are keeping the values. On the place of a and b, we are putting 3x and 7y. Now, this will become 9x square, this will become 49y square, and here we are putting the value now. 3x minus 7y is 10, so we are putting 10 here, 10 square plus 2, 3, 6, 7 is 42. xy, in the place of xy, we are putting minus 1. Okay, so this will become 100 plus minus minus 42, and 100 minus 42 is 58. And that is your answer. Got it? It's very easy to do this kind of questions. Okay? Now, let me show you another example. Okay? From the RD Sharma. This is also having a different kind of question. I hope you all are understanding what I am reciting here. Okay? Please try to do it accordingly. See, maths is not a difficult subject. The difficulty is in our mind, okay? Because maths is need your focus and your determination for doing the sum, okay? If you are having courage to do so, you will love maths. Otherwise, it won't matter whether you do or not. Okay, now let's see one more example of it. Here I am having some simplified questions. Simplify the product. Simplify the product. Okay. Here we are having a question. Question is 2x to the power 4 minus 4x square plus 1 and 2x to the power 4 minus 2x square minus 1. Now, see, what I have told you in last class also, you don't need to afraid by looking the question. The question seems a bit difficult, but its solution is right if you are approaching it in right way. So, see here, if you observe it properly, what you are seeing here is, these first two terms are of same sign and same term. But this last term, plus 1, is having different sign. Okay, so we can assume these first two terms as a one combined term as A and the other term as B. So that you can see, we can apply easily A plus B, A minus B identity here, which is A square minus B square. So what should we do here? We can square the first term, which is 2x to the power 4 minus 4x square whole square minus 1 square. Because we assume this whole term as a one term combinedly, that's why we are squaring it alone. Now, see, after applying one identity, you should apply another identity if it is applicable here. As you can see, there are two terms in this whole term and it is having a whole square. We can open the bracket by applying the identity. Now we are applying identity here as a minus b whole square. It will be a square plus b square minus 2a, because minus in between them, so 2, our a is 2x to the power 4 and our b is 4x square. Okay, so this is a square plus b square minus 2ab, and minus 1 square is existing, so that we can write it afterwards. Now, squaring these terms individually and solve it together, this will become 4x to the power 8, this will become 16x to the power 4, this will become 2 2's are 4, 4's are 16, x to the power 6 minus 8. Remember that power will added on when multiplication, and if power is having one power, power will be multiplied. You have remembered the 7th power addition rule that will applicable here. Your answer is not in proper form. We can arrange it in descending order powers, so that 4x to the power 8 minus 16x to the power 6 plus 16x to the power 4 minus 1. That would be your proper answer for this question. Okay? Likewise, you can do different sums of the identity. Okay, few more examples I am showing you here from the same chapter. Let's move on to the other exercise. In other exercise, there are also mixed terms kind of questions. These mixed term kind of questions exist
the value of the different term, and we need to find the answer for the combined term. Like you can see, here it is given an example. I'm taking as an example for here the value of term given is a square plus b square plus c square is 16. So a square plus b square plus c square is equals to 16. And another term is given to us is ab bc ca. So ab plus bc plus ca, which is 10, is given to us. We need to find the value of a, b, c. So we need to find the value for a plus b plus c here. Okay, this two term value already given to us. Now how to use them together? See, we are here applying the formula for the square of the three terms. Formula I am writing here, which is a plus b plus c whole square, that is a square plus b square plus c square plus 2ab plus bc plus ca. Okay, now I am putting the values here. See, a plus b plus c value we need to find, so I am writing it like that as it is. A square plus b square plus c square is given 16 to us, and ab plus bc plus ca is given 10 to us. This 16 and 20, 2 tens are 20, will become 36, which is 6 square. So a plus b plus c whole square is equal to 6 square. By taking square root, we can get the value of a plus b plus c is equal to plus minus 6. Remember again, why plus minus 6? Because plus 6 square is also 36 and minus 6 square is also 36. Okay. Few more questions from the cubic identity now. Sir, please switch off this one. This one. Now we are moving on to cubical identities. In cubical identity, there are also some questions existing, like x plus a, x plus b. Now I am taking here as x minus 1 by x equal to 7. We need to find x cube minus 1 by x cube. Okay, now see how to find the value. Here a minus b is given, so it's obvious that we need to apply a cubic formula for a minus b whole cube. So a minus b whole cube, if you remember, this formula is a cube minus b cube minus 3ab a minus b. Okay. Or you can apply a cube minus b cube formula also, which is a minus b, a square plus ab plus b square. And you can also apply a square plus b square formula in terms of a minus b. If you remember, that is a minus b whole square plus 2ab, and this ab also exists, so that it will become a new formula now we are forming. It will be a minus b whole square and plus 3ab. Now we just put the value here. See, we need to find x cube minus 1 by x cube, and this formula also for a cube minus b cube. So we have our a is x and our b is 1 by x. Now apply that formula. In place of a, I am writing x. In place of b, I am writing 1 by x here. Now in bracket, x minus 1 by x whole square plus 3x 1 by x. Now I am trying to solve it. This x will get cancelled. Okay, x cube minus 1 by x cube will be 7. In bracket, 7 square plus 3. So 7 square is 49 plus 3 is 52. And 7 into 52 is 364. That is your answer. Okay, it's very simple multiplication. Okay, 52 weeks, complete weeks in our whole year. So that 52 into 7 days in a week, it will be 364 days. And one more day extra will be there in the normal year. So it's like that. Okay. So one more last thing, we are moving on to other exercise. There are some few more questions of like that also. Let's see that. Okay. See, now we have done a cube plus b cube, a cube minus b cube formulas. Now see, if a plus b is given to a is 8, a plus b is equal to 8, and a into b is given to us 6. Okay, here we need to find the value of a cube plus b cube. Now how you can apply the formula for that. We are simply just applying the formula of a whole cube. That would be what? That would be a plus b whole cube is equals to a cube plus b cube. So that this value will be, we will find out, and plus 3ab a plus b. Just keep the values as it is. A plus b is 8, so that 8 cube is equal to a cube plus b cube, the value we need to find. 3ab is 6 and a plus b is 8. Now 8 cube is 512. Okay, you need to know the cubes and the square. Square till 25 and cubes till 15 at least, if you want to learn 9. Okay, now here a cube plus b cube. Now we are multiplying these three terms together. 3 6 are 18 and 18 8s are. 18 8s are how much? 144. Yes, correct. 144 is opposing to the other side, so that a cube plus b cube will become 512 minus 144. Now just subtracting it. 12 minus 4 is 8. 50 minus 14 is 36. And that would be your answer, 368. That's how you can do the sums now of different kinds of the questions in algebraic identities like this when you are having different values. Please keep trying different sums like that. Okay, till then, stay safe, stay blessed, and keep studying and enjoy your study. Thank you.